If you don't know, now you know. If you don't know, now you know. It's the Ask Rayceen Show.
Welcome to the penultimate edition of the Ask Rayceen Show. For our 10th and final season, we are online and available worldwide. I'm your announcer, Krylios. On behalf of Team Rayceen Productions, I thank all of our sponsors, including DC Homas, Bite the Fruit, and Whitman Walker Health. To learn more about our sponsors, guests, Team Rayceen Productions, and more, please use the links in this video's description. It is now my pleasure to introduce our host, the High Priestess of Love, the Queen of the Shameless Plug, the Empress of Pride, the Goddess of DC, the iconic, the legendary, Rayceen Pendarvis.
Greetings and salutations. Thanks for joining us, and welcome to the Ask Rayceen Show. I hope you had a good autumn. This year is almost over. I started my autumn with the Ask Rayceen Show Day on September the 1st. We thank Mayor Bowser for this amazing honor. Halloween will be here soon. Do you have a costume? Some have been naughty nurses. Some have been Cinderella, even Snow White, or the evil, wicked queen. Whatever you choose to be safe. Will you be tricking or treating? In the past, some of you have tricked, and some of you got 9 to 5. Those who don't want to be tricking anymore, but just treating and enjoying themselves. Remember, be safe, and most of all, be you. Election Day is coming up. Are you registered to vote? Please vote in your local election. Vote early, vote by mail, vote in person, however you can. Headcount is a wonderful organization. Hello to Chris and all the volunteers. Headcount has been with us, registering voters and sharing information with the attendees of the Ask Rayceen Show since 2016. To make sure you are vote ready, text Team Rayceen to 40649 or visit headcount.org. To watch our spring and summer editions, please visit AskRayceen.com and please subscribe to Team Rayceen YouTube channel. Thanks for being here and supporting us. We have a terrific lineup. Check it out. Up next is music by the delightful Deborah Bond.
Deborah Bond performed on the Ask Rayceen Show in October 2019, and her new album is available now.
Hey, y'all. It's Deborah here. I am so excited and thrilled to be joining you for the penultimate edition of the Ask Rayceen Show. My first performance with the Ask Rayceen Show back in October 2019 ended up being one of the final shows in front of a live audience. Thanks for having me back for your 10th and final season. Congratulations, Rayceen! Woo!
Must it feel so good? Can't
help ourselves, we move so fast. And it's a shame for us, yeah. The losing side of the game. Let's do what's best for us and write a classic love song for the radio. Sing it, beautiful baby. Playtime is over. Let's lay it down today. One to believe in fairy tales, but honey, you bring out my inner child. Laugh and play with you, living the life of the free, free, free. Yeah, what? Huh. But as the story goes, we may not have seen what's okay, and now these words are hard to write. 'Cause I never. Let's do what's best for us and write a classic love song for the radio. Sing it, beautiful baby. Playtime is over. Let's lay it down today. I hope that you hear me, 'cause I really love you. Let's lay it down. Doubting once you're the one. that you love me for. Keep on moving, don't stop. hands of time, tick-tock. Find your own way to stay, yeah. The time will come one day. Keep on moving, keep on moving, don't stop, no. Keep on moving, yeah, yeah. To stay, yeah. The time will come one day. Oh, 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 moving. Oh, don't stop. Oh, no. Tick tock. Find your own way to stay. The time will come one day. Hey. Congratulations on 10 years of the Ask Rayceen show. Rayceen, you know I love you. You know I think you are fantastic and fabulous. And I know you are on to bigger and more beautiful and even more exciting things.
Yes, keep on moving, Rayceen.
I sure will. Who's next?
Up next is a poem by the multi-talented Gina Nicole Brown.
Sublime, you might say, and you wouldn't be wrong. A place where you, me, and them could all belong. Advocacy, community, and love so strong. It took 10 years to sing this swan song. We came to sing, rap, spit, and twirl. Month after month, you'd watch us unfurl, dropping gems glowing brighter than mother of pearl. Trouble so good, your legs and toes would curl. Art and open dialogue were always in the zone. No topic too tough. We'd open every stone. Heart to heart and bone to bone. You'd come by yourself, but never be alone. Doors wide open, safe to find this space. Inclusive to all, religions, gender, and race. We loved our elders and all their grace. Young and old, we're welcome in this place. The stories we heard, the laughter we felt, the lives we changed, the pain we dealt, the skin we shed like an animal's pelt, walls and divisions began to melt. Led by the light of the Empress, Goddess, and Queen, Rayceen Pendarvis lovingly hosted the scene. Growing to include help from a beautiful team. Nothing but love could you glean. It was called the Ask Rayceen Show, as if you didn't know. And for 10 years, it was the place to go. Artists, politicians, and authors came to grow. And the goddess of DC, Rayceen Pendarvis, let them flow and glow. Every month was different, but it fit like a glove. Cages were opened, like releasing a dove. New pathways and friendships formed, in spite of, enveloped in a human armor of love.
Is this the final panel discussion?
Yes, the final retrospective panel segment, Pandemic, Hiatus, and Pivot. Ooh. Welcome to the fifth of our five retrospective panels discussing the history and legacy of the Ask Rayceen Show. This discussion focuses on the past 2 years, beginning with our final pre-pandemic show or season premiere in March 2020 and concluding with our 10th and final season, online and available worldwide. Let's start by having the panelists introduce themselves and each sharing a memory or anecdote about the Ask Rayceen Show. Let's start with PoetRaeMonet.
Oh, well, hello, everyone. I am PoetRaeMonet. I am the hashtag Ask Rayceen Poet Laureate for the 2020 year. I also just happen to be the first and only Poet Laureate for the Ask Rayceen Show. I am also an author as well as a visual artist, well as a can maker and producer. I have a lot of things. But the point is that I've had an absolutely marvelous time working with the team at Ask Rayceen and working with Team Rayceen in general. You know, in terms of an anecdote, I don't even want to focus on something specific. I just want to talk about all of those in-between moments. You know, the moments before the show begins or after the show ends, when all of Team Rayceen gets to actually talk to each other. Back, you know, pre-pandemic times when we could give each other a hug or, you know, a high five and just really come together in that moment of just congregation. It's so important because as artists, we're always giving a piece of ourselves away. And that is my solid moment to get a little bit of recharge for my family at Team Rayceen.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, PoetRaeMonet. Let's move on to José.
Hi, everyone. My name's José Romero. I am also known as DC Homos. You can follow us on all social media. We're always causing good trouble. We have been a sponsor of the Ask Rayceen Show the last couple years. There to provide basically anything Rayceen wants because he deserves it. So, you know, every year Czar really pushes me to get creative with the things that we do, the things that we give to the volunteers, and, you know, making the experience amazing. With so many queer and gay spaces in DC disappearing, the Ask Rayceen Show always felt like home. Walking in, you always felt welcome.
We love that. We love that. And thank you, José, for being a sponsor for such a long time. Thank you so much. Next, let's go to Gina.
Hi, I'm Gina Nicole Brown. I'm an actor and comedian and performance artist. And Let's see, my favorite memory, so many like everybody else has said, but my favorite memory is when I brought my daughters to a show at HRC, and my daughter Gabrielle got up to do a part in the dance contest, and she actually won, and it was just so crazy when she got a bag of goodies as her treat, and I think the bags were for, you know, most of the adults. So she brought home the treats and she was like, is this candy? It's like, yeah, it is, baby, but not for you. So, that's probably my favorite memory. And Rayceen was always so wonderful with my girls and just, oh, they love Rayceen. So that's my favorite memory.
Beautiful, beautiful. Kia, hey, how are you? Welcome.
I am wonderful and blessed. So I'm Kia and I'm a singer, and I've had the pleasure to perform with Key Day, our duo, for the Rayceen show. And my favorite is every single time, the grand entrance. I live for that. Right?
Yes, honey, the entrance. You always know it's something coming through when those doors come open.
All the time.
And yes.
I'm looking forward to the energy all the time, seeing what Rayceen has on, the song choice, the lighting. I love it. Everything.
It's always a production. Always a production. Yeah. Thanks so much, Kia. Mm-hmm. Carly.
Hi, I'm Carly Harvey. I'm a singer, songwriter, and I didn't get involved with the Ask Rayceen show until the pandemic hit. So all of my interviews and performances have been virtual. I don't know if I can think of like a favorite experience, but I can just say like, I guess my first interview was with Krylios and Rayceen, and it just went so like smoothly. I've sat through some interviews that are like awkward or like weird questions or like, or people digging, they're like, so what's your love life like? And they know good and well. But like, it just felt like I had known them forever. And so I'm so happy to be connected with this family, is what it really is, this beautiful family and community. And regardless of being able to be there live or virtually, it feels really good to be part of it. So
thank you. We lean into familiarity and community here at Team Rayceen. Yes. Desiree. What about you?
Hey everyone, my name is Desiree Jordan. I am a singer, songwriter, musician, wellness jewelry advocate and creator. And I'm also one half of Key Day. We had the opportunity and joy to perform at the Ask Rayceen show several times and just with Rayceen for years. And honestly, what everyone has said so far has been in my mind as some of my favorite things. The family, the inclusivity, the love. I think the fact that every time with every Ask Rayceen show, you just know what you're gonna get. It's gonna be fabulous, period. But you also don't know what you're gonna get. And one of my favorite things about that surprise is seeing how much talent and love there is in the DC and DMV area that is just available to share. Like, you can just tell that Rayceen is love, and everyone that's affiliated with Rayceen is just straight up love. So
yes, honey, love me, the world go round. Thank you, Desiree. And Gina is dying. And let us round it out with Jewel.
Hi everyone, my name is Jewel. I work in the external affairs department at Whitman Walker Health here in DC, and my pronouns are she, her, hers. And I think my favorite moment about going to the Ask Rayceen show was honestly just seeing the dedication of your team, of the czars, of the Krylios, of the Niqui's of the world. You could tell that with every move and every show that they made in that space to make that show happen that night. There was just so much passion and love behind it. So it was really something spectacular to see such a machine moving in cohesion together. And working towards this common goal of creating community space that really felt like it was for any person in community. So thank you for all that y'all have done to keep that space going all these years.
Thank you, Jewel. And the last person I'll have speak is Rayceen.
Oh, I'd just like to say personally to each one of you, thank you for your love, your time, your energy. Thank you for believing in me, believing in Team Rayceen, always saying yes when it's hard in a world of no's. It's so great to hear yes from all of these wonderful, talented individuals. You know, this has been a journey getting here, 10 years of my life, you know, and I must say, this is the one panel that y'all have just brought so much joy to me, where I had the joy, the happiness, the love, the feeling is so overwhelming that I feel really good. And I'm in a place, I think I've cried enough over the last panels that I will not cry on this. I will not cry on this one. I said, do not break down today. So, you know, I'm just feeling, because it just feels happy, happy, happy. You know, even in the emotions, I feel the joy and the love. You know, I think about Gia and her children and my Capricorn sister who makes me smile, you know? And I think about Carly, the queen of the blues, you know? And here she is, you know? I've seen her, but never met her. And then I feel the love instantly from the moment we connected. Desiree, knowing her family, knowing before I knew her, and I'd seen her and heard about her and all this wonderful things that she does. And then seeing her, that light that I know that comes from that beautiful family, that all of that is from who she is and sharing her gift with the world and with us. And Jewel from Whitman Walker, who has been just to keep us afloat and keep us alive in those little, those believing in the Ask Rayceen show when it was the times when it was really hard to get it going. And Jewel was one of those people on the front line with Whitman Walker pushing and believing and making sure that she had the lit help. She put the coal in the engine for the little train that could. And to José, the first time I met him, I knew he was my brother. And he just came along and he just was so loving and so wonderful and so warming. And he believed in us when sometimes I didn't believe in myself. When those days when I was doubting, could we go on? And having him donate and say, oh yes, it can happen. It's gonna work. We're gonna make it happen. Let us know that what we were doing was the right thing. And Kia, this beautiful young lady who I've seen, you know, I've seen her a lot. Kia has been this background diva for every artist in the world. And then she shares her gift as an artist, as a writer, as she comes to the stage and brings so much joy and love and so much yes. And that's what I love about her. And our beloved poet, Ray Monet. Oh my God. The sassy, funk, sexuality. She's a teacher, she's a preacher, she's a prophet. She's all of those things, but she's my friend. And that's what I love. She uses words to enlighten us, move us, motivate us, make us get hot, make us feel that we are beautiful with our curves, that it shimmies and shakes and moves, and we are everything. And it's okay to be sexual and be free. And she allows us to celebrate that in our goodness and in our joy. And she has been on this journey with us for quite some time. And I am so glad and so honored to say, she's not my friend, she's one of my sisters. And I thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. I thank you all. And to Team Rayceen, Krylios, Niqui, Czar. Czar cracks the whip. He's like the, you don't see him. He's like the Charlie in the voice in the box on the desk that guards it. Tells his angels, make sure the assignment is done. Make sure everything is done. And we all say, okay, Charlie, you know, and I cannot do this without him. And to Brittany and Rod and Jason and Donald, all of those wonderful volunteers who are part of this journey with us and those who come and have gone and all of the places and the spaces that we have been. What a joy, what a blessing. And all of the people who came and celebrated with us. A safe space I created, but you can't have safety without the guards of safety. And all of you have been a part of this journey as the guards of safety and creating a safe space, which is called the Ask Rayceen Show. So I'm so honored and so moved, and I thank you all.
Thank you, Rayceen. That was really, really lovely. Now, let's begin with the season premiere on March 4, 2020. For those of us who were there, just as COVID-19 began to become a concern, what do you remember about that evening? Anyone want to try that one? Who was there?
Kia? Let me just tell you, it was so funny. Desiree and I have on the same thing today that we had on at that show. I'm just like looking at the picture right now. I'm like, so funny.
I love that. I love that. I love that. Great minds. Beautiful.
I just noticed that when I saw the picture just now.
Yes. PoetRaeMonet, you were also there, your first time and last time on the stage as the Poet Laureate.
You know, first of all, I know Rayceen said, don't cry. So I'm over here trying to, hit corners real quick. That was really was a beautiful show. It was packed out. As I remember, I actually invited a friend to come to see that show. And she really enjoyed it and actually wanted to be a part of Team Rayceen, kind of moving forward, because she was so struck, by the spirit of the love and camaraderie and just the community that was in the room. I remember that that was the same day that I received paper copy of the query. I was in the newspaper that day, which was crazy. So that I have Rayceen and Zara to thank, for that, because that blew my mind. We had not only that incredible performance by Kide, I remember also that we had all of the vendors that were there, that we had like it was like a shameless plug train. I know that sounds crazy, but it was so wonderful because everyone just got up there and they were able to get a couple of seconds out to tell everybody, hey, this is what I'm doing. This is how you can support me. This is how it goes. Like, this is what you can do. And that's one of the things that I always loved about the Ask Rayceen show as well, because it's not just about Rayceen. It's about supporting the community, letting the community get those resources, connecting the community with people in the community. Like, it's always been about that cohesiveness and that just, again, that love and that care. And it was definitely present that night. I remember it being a very fun night. And I remember our bartender being really good too.
I certainly remember that night as well. I remember Rayceen and I were together that whole day because we were like getting stuff together for the premiere. We were also vlogging. And every time I watch that vlog, it just brings me back to that time. You know, we weren't really sure what the pandemic was giving yet. Like, we did not know what was going on. Things were just coming out. And every time I rewatch that vlog to see just this very different life that we used to live. And it was like, we were talking about what could happen, what it is. But we were also very, very, very much excited about the show. Who would have thought that would have been, it was our premiere, but it was actually our last show before COVID started. And it was a fabulous show too. It was also the first show where I was the official announcer. I'm no longer the pre-announcer. I was now the announcer. And so, it was a fabulous show. We had a grand entrance. It was really giving. I I remember it a lot to this day because it was very, very fun. And it was, you know, great coming back. A premiere is always great, you know, having everybody come back together, seeing people you haven't seen since, you know, the fall, because it was a long winter, honey. And we were ready to be back together. And then we went back in right afterwards. We came up and went right back in afterwards. Rayceen, what are some of your favorite moments from that final March 2020 show at HRC?
Wow. Not knowing that would be the last time I'd be on stage, you know? So, I mean, at least I can say, honey, we went out with a bang. You know, the last time I mean, it was such a place full of so much joy and love. So I don't feel bad about it. I just felt like, oh, there's so much more coming. If you could only see what was getting ready to happen. And you know what? But I can still feel good about it because I think of everybody who was there and the people were there. It was just so much love and love just radiated. So if I could say that, hey, that was our last show in HRC, that it was a day full of love. So I am so happy for that.
I'm actually so, so glad that we documented it now, that when I think about it, because it really captures all that love, all of that, you know, within that vlog when you watch it. It captures all of it, just the great times we had, the great moments, so many laughs within it. And, you know, everyone is there, everyone is featured. So I'm so glad that we have kept that as a little time capsule. And, you know, you can check that out on the Team Rayceen YouTube channel. Yes, you can. And see our final show there. So while we are on that topic, let's move on to something else. So all of you have contributed to our success. Therefore, we thank you. What compelled you all to become involved with the Ask Rayceen show? So I'm gonna throw that one out and I'm gonna pick someone first. Let's go with José.
Wow. So if anyone knows my story, I actually am from the area, but right after college I moved to Miami, and about 12 years ago I think I moved to DC. And you know, it was tough really finding a niche, like where I fit in, and, you know, found a good group of friends, but it was very basic, you know, the kickball, the drunk brunches, Sunday fun days. I mean, those were fun, but when you get to a certain age, you know, and then, you know, getting personal, I was going through a period where I had a lot of medical conditions, was in and out of the hospital, was actually in a coma, you know, lots of medical problems. So I was at home with lots of free time to tweet about things and post about things. And, you know, when Rayceen and Czar reached out to me, hey, come live tweet this event. Like we had never live tweeted an event, you know, and that opportunity really opened so much for us. You know, we grew because of the Ask Rayceen show, along with the Ask Rayceen show, you know. And, you know, even though it was tough for me at that time, health-wise, to get out, I made it out there. You know, I still remember that day, the people that I met, everyone was so incredibly welcoming. I think it was the talent show at Club Live. And I had no idea that this community existed in DC, you know? And I was like, why don't people know about this? Like, we need to spread the word. We need to make this bigger. This is such an amazing space, you know? So got more involved, kept coming. For work, I travel a lot, you know, and somehow I still managed to make it to almost every single show. So I actually had to look back at my Facebook photos and I was like, okay, I remember I was there at that March premiere, always taking photos. And you know, lots of times I'm always very busy, so I can't always donate my time, but I do know that, you know, we live in, you know, capitalist America where it costs money to do things, you know, and the fact that this show is free, it's a free space to see amazing artists, poets, you know, the talent show, we've had classical cellists, you know, compete, dancers. It's just such a platform for everything amazing and beautiful in DC. So whenever I get a text from Czar, I'm like, okay, how much is this going to cost me?
Yes, I love it. Actually, I'm so gagged that the Ask Rayceen show was the first show you ever live tweeted.
It was, and you know, and at the time, really we probably had maybe 10,000, 15,000 followers on Twitter. And now we have about 90,000. You know, wow, so with wow, that with wow. that exposure, you know, getting invited to do things, you know, I've spoken at GW for, you know, about intersectionality. I've traveled to like Charlotte Pride. I've spoken at Latinx Pride. You know, if it wasn't for the Ask Rayceen show, I would not have had those opportunities.
And we thank you all. We thank you so much for all that you've done to help with building this show. Thank you so much. Anybody else? What got you involved? Let's go with Desiree, then let's go to Kia.
Awesome.
And then let's go to Joel.
So Kia and I, as Kide, were affiliated with Rayceen back in 2017, outside of and before the Ask Rayceen show. And what's so special about having been involved with Rayceen and Team Rayceen and the Ask Rayceen show is not just the entertainment aspect. It was more than just exposure, which is fabulous for anyone that is an artist of any kind. But what really stands out to me and honestly to the both of us and why we stayed engaged with Rayceen and the Ask Rayceen show is that we were able to uplift people through the power of our art, one of our arts, which is music. Music is a healing modality. Music is something that reaches right into the heart and soul of any and everybody. And so from singing at a senior center to singing, you know, or being a part of Rayceen in different avenues, it was just sort of like, duh, like, of course we'd want to be a part of Ask Rayceen show more than, you know, oh, let's participate. But it was actually like, you know, how can we serve? And that's what's so special about the Ask Rayceen show is that it's serving our community. It's serving the people of every race, every creed, every, you know, preference. Like every single person is welcome. And every single person has an opportunity to just feel the love emanating from each other. So that for me is very, very special and just automatically is like, yeah, of course we'd be participating with Rayceen. Like anything Rayceen does, give us a call. If we're here, if we're available, let's do it. So
love it. Love it. Thanks, Desiree. Kia.
So Rayceen, let's see if you remember this. So I first met Rayceen in 2011 when I was the community outreach coordinator for the DC Board of Elections, and somebody sashays up in the front desk. I said, who is this star? Right? I'm like, who? And they said, you know, I met Rayceen because you were bringing in your, what were you bringing in? You were bringing in petitions because you were running for ANC.
Sure.
Right? Mm. And you gave me a flyer. I was like, oh, what is this? And so then I came to the Rayceen show at the library downtown. What was that? MLK?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So I was like, okay, one of these days I'm going to be in this talent show. Because at that time, Yasra was the guest that night. Wow. Yes. Do you remember that Rayceen? So then I would start seeing you everywhere after that. Because you would come into the office all the time. I was like, that's my boo.
Yeah, I love it. Joelle, what about you?
Oh, wow. I think for myself and Whitman Walker Health and you know, my colleagues, this has just been a no-brainer of an event to be part of and try to support as best as we could. I remember when my colleague used to go to the shows early on and try to kind of come back to our team and explain the essence and the ambiance and the love and the diversity and just the different experiences that you could have all in that one same room. And I don't think I really got it until I attended the show for myself. You had everyone from poets to singers to DJs to creators to creatives to politicians to healthcare folks to folks who were creating their own skin products because nothing had served their skin properly beforehand. So it was just this beautiful hub of innovation that you know, Rayceen and Team Rayceen were really fostering, and people really felt like they could share themselves and be open and be themselves. And the audience was always so you know, filled with just different people. So we knew that this was a space for community and we needed to be a part of supporting that. So thank you all for all that you've done to create that space and make it so safe and keep it going for all these years. And Walker Hall is so proud to have been a part of the story.
Thank you. And we thank Wayman Walker Health for all the help that they've given the Team Rayceen Productions and the Ask Rayceen show over the years. You know, what's really interesting is that when I first went to Howard to start school there, you know, I wanted to know what was the community like. I also wanted to know gay people, meet other gay people. You know, I was coming from a non-gay place, and so of course I followed DC homos. Like maybe within the first month I moved to DC, and so I was seeing like the live tweets and all of that too. So then I knew what the Ask Rayceen show was before, you know, I had ever gone or anything. And then I remember it was Black Pride. I was at Black Pride one of the years, and I saw Rayceen for the first time ever. And it was at speed dating. It was a speed dating event at Black Pride. And that was the first time I met Rayceen and Zar. And literally later that year, there I was scrolling on Twitter, and I really wanted to be engaged with the community, you know, really wanted to do something to put myself within the community. And I saw, you know, outreach for some volunteers, and I DM'd Zar, and the rest is history. And, you know, I am so, so happy that I got involved with Team Rayceen Productions and the Ask Rayceen show. I am, you know, it's just given so much to me, so much to my life, you know, put me within the community. I don't think I could really say, like, I felt like I was a DC person, you know, until, you know, because I just met so, so, so many people across the entire region. You know, I've learned the beat of the city, the beat of the rhythm through the Ask Rayceen show and Team Rayceen Productions. And so, you know, I had to get involved, and I'm thankful to this day that I did. So thank you all to everyone who's you know, given time, who's given effort, who's given even a thought to the Ask Rayceen show and helping to build it to what it is today. Thank you all so, 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 so much. Now let us move on, because we do want to acknowledge that this year, Carly Harvey created the first theme song for the Ask Rayceen show. Something our producers are had wanted someone to do for many, many, many years. So thank you so much, Carly. Carly, anything to say?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I was very honored to be asked. I think Zara said, could you do this for us? And I was like, who, me? I was like, oh, do you mean you're just asking if other people can do it? Do I know someone? And he's like, no, can you do it? And I'm like, And I was like, absolutely. I thought it was a really cool thing. And sorry, I don't want to go on too long, but as Rayceen said, we've never met in person. I think she's been to a couple of my shows, but we didn't meet in person. And then the rest of it has been just like keeping track with what I'm doing with my music. So I feel very seen, especially by someone who recognizes and acknowledges like good spirits, good souls, and that I'm one of those people that she saw, and you guys just really embraced me. So it's been like super, just super duper an honor to be able to do that for you guys.
Thank you so much, Carly.
Of course.
So we are going to wrap it up. So before we wrap it up, we want each guest to share what they hope to see from Rayceen Pendarvis and Team Rayceen Productions in the future. So let us start it out with Gina Nicole Brown.
Yeah, you know, I just, is it corny to say keep hope alive? Because I just want Rayceen to keep showing up for those that don't have a voice or those that need to be reminded that they do have a voice and a presence. And I think with Rayceen and Team Rayceen's help, people around the community will realize, oh, I also can do this and I can take the torch and I can lead on. So just keep dropping your knowledge just in love and, you know, energy everywhere across this DMV area.
Beautiful, beautiful. Let's go to PoetRaeMonet.
Well, you know, one of the things that I'd like to see from Team Rayceen is just the, you know, as really it's echoing kind of what Gina was saying, just the continuation of reaching out. I mean, you know, maybe we can't do the Ask Rayceen show, but maybe quarterly we could do Rayceen Hour or something. And then we can all just come back and, you know, just come back just for a little while, you know, and pretend like it's, you know, those vibrant days again, and then go away and part our separate ways. And then we come back and we get another hug and it just holds us for a little while. And then we're able to let go again. And, you know, just don't cut us off cold turkey. We can't do it. Okay. We just, I need a little fix every once in a while and we'll be okay.
I love it. I would like to see that. Well, we'll always have things going on here at Team Rayceen Productions. Of course we will. Let's see who is next on the roster. Let's go to Carly. Carly, what do you hope to see from Team Rayceen Productions and Rayceen Pendarvis in the future?
So I have wild desires, but you know how when Oprah ended her show and everybody was really sad and then it was like, you know, still for a moment, and then it was like, boom, network. I was like, is there like a Team Rayceen network which would have documentaries and like supporting like the arts, supporting the LGBT plus community? Yeah, and then a different manifestation of the show. Like Raymonet said, like, you know, Rayceen Hour, right? You know, like the whatever that thing is she does where she just sits down with one person and they just like get like a feel of soulfulness, you know? I mean, but yeah, I mean, those are my wild desires.
I love it. José, what about you?
You know, there isn't a stage big enough for Rayceen. I would really love to expand Rayceen's reach outside of DC. You know, she's known in a lot of places, but, you know, one idea that we've always toyed with is, you know, let's do a show in Philly, you know, get together. There's a great POC LGBTQ queer community in Philly. Let's do it, you know, let's spread the love. I want to see Rayceen perform and host at Pride's up and down the East Coast, you know, and start from there.
I love it, love it, love it. Kia, what about you?
I mean, I was totally going to say Rayceen do a tour. Like, I see Rayceen as, I don't know, expansion and next level blessings, because, you know, when one door closes, another one opens. But for right now, and I'm going to say this because I just recently got a grant from the DC Commission on the Arts to finish my album. Rayceen, it's money out there for us, especially you being a DC icon. You can get grants like nothing to continue to do what you do, like through podcasts or the tour. Like, they will finance your tour up and down the East Coast. Like, you just have to let them know, because, you know, they want DC artists and personalities and organizations to expand. You know, they want people to see what goes on here in DC. You know, you could easily get this and do this. mean, because I really feel that you have a larger than life energy, a light, and something to say. I see expansion and next level blessings everywhere. Like, I really do see you on TV. You know, I was really mad when I didn't see you on polls on the panel.
Speak on it.
Every time I saw it, I was like, oh my God, I wish Rayceen could just be on this panel.
Well, I was supposed to be in the final season, but COVID shut that down.
Right, because you know what? I saw someone in the house of Pendarvis.
We were there from the beginning.
Yeah.
Anybody though wants to see Rayceen on a panel reading the girls, judging the girls,
I would love it.
There's a new music video out right now by Benue Bird where Rayceen appears on the judging panel. You know, the girls are voguing and Rayceen is judging, honey.
I'm telling you.
So you get a piece of that.
All of it. I want to see you on a panel. I would love to see you on a panel.
Yes,
a lot in the works in 2022.
Yes, Joel, what about you? What do you want to see in the future for Rayceen and Team Rayceen Productions?
I think I've got to echo the wants for the continued love and light and sharing that energy, the continued desires for the tour. I definitely love to see Ask Rayceen or just Rayceen on tour. I keep thinking back to these two events that we worked on together where you hosted spaces for our youth programming and just the ways in which you're able to connect with the audience of young people and just really left people feeling inspired about continuing to create and continuing to pursue their creative dreams. And that's a blessing in itself. And I'm just so grateful for the way that you're able to connect with people who you speak with and kind of light that fire of inspiration and drive. So I want to continue to see that.
Fabulous. And to round it out, let's have Desiree.
What I want for and from Rayceen and Team Rayceen Productions is simple. There's the last song on my EP says, I ain't going nowhere. I ain't going nowhere. Best believe that I will be there. That's it. I just want Rayceen to be there. Wherever she might end up, it doesn't even matter because we know that love is there. We know that light is there. We know that peace and inclusion and community is there. So wherever it is that God sends you and brings you through, you ain't going nowhere. And that's all I want.
I love it. I love it. Thank you all. And just a reminder to everyone out there, the Ask Rayceen show may be ending, but Team Rayceen Productions will continue. So there is much, 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 much more in store for you. So I thank everyone. I thank you all for your time. And on behalf of Team Rayceen Productions, I hope we have the opportunity to collaborate with you all in the future. Thank you all. Rayceen and I are taking this time to recognize some of the people who have had a significant impact on the Ask Rayceen show. First, we thank all of our volunteers, including Donald, Brittany, Jason, Audrey, Rod, and so many others. We thank the photographers who volunteered their time and talents, including Jeff, Ron, Lori, Kizzy, Monique, Michael, Rachel, Chanel, and Namdi. We thank our sponsors, past and present, including Whitman Walker Health, Bite the Fruit, DC Homers, J Walking Productions, Capital Medical Associates, AHF Pharmacy, Real Affirmations, the Raven Group, Comfort Zone, and our very first sponsor, Spunk Lube. We also want to acknowledge two groups of people who have been fundamental to the success of the Ask Rayceen show, announcers and DJs. We started with guest announcers in 2014. In 2015, DH, the hit writer, took on a role which would be developed soon thereafter as that of announcer by Chelsea Short and Kurt Mariah. Kurt Mariah would continue into 2016, and when she became unavailable due to a scheduling conflict, we were joined by Chris J and Anthony Oakes. Anthony Oakes became the longest serving announcer, continuing on to 2017, 2018, and ending in 2019. In 2020, Krylios, that's me, became the final person in the role of announcer. We've had several guest DJs over the years. The ones who volunteered their time most frequently were DJ Suspense, DJ Honey, DJ Hayes, DJ Mim, DJ Heat, DJ Rosie, and the late, great Juan Allure. We thank them all for contributing to our success. We lost several frequent collaborators in 2020, but let's first discuss someone who passed away in 2018, Team Rayceen volunteer and archivist, Vance Matthews. Rayceen, what do you remember about Vance?
He was a sweet and kind and loving individual. He always believed in making sure that our community is accountable, and meaning accountable that our history, and a part of our history was the Ask Rayceen Show. So he found things about me that I had forgotten that I did. And he created this amazing website that told a story of my life in a way that had me, when I first saw it, I was so overwhelmed, I cried. And he was that kind of giving and loving soul that was very quiet, very always in the background, but observing everything. And I know he's looking down and smiling upon us. And may he rest in peace and power.
Certainly. And, you know, Vance was really amazing. He created and maintained the now defunct website for the Ask Rayceen Show and created the original promotional videos. So rest in power, Vance. Rayceen, say a few words about poet Venus Thrash, who succumbed to illness this past summer.
Venus was a powerful poet, an amazing light. Venus brought to the stage the power of a comet that possessed this greatness, that once it hit the stage, it just consumed it. And she was that, all of that, was such an amazing soul, full of creativity, full of love, full of joy, who just loved the world. And I believe, and like all comets, they come, they move, they create, and then they're gone.
Certainly, certainly. Now, the aforementioned Juan Allure, yes, yes, yes. The aforementioned Juan Allure. Let us talk about Juan Allure a little bit. What do you remember about Juan?
What I loved about Juan is he used music as a teacher. He used music as a tool. He made sure he always told a story. He made sure he always had a kind word. Wherever I would see him playing, he was this international acclaimed DJ. He had opened the door for so many people. He was in places that only a few can imagine. He was this amazing star in his own right, but he was so gracious and kind. Whenever we asked him, he was always there, especially when it came to the Biddy Bowl. He
was scheduled
to be there. He said, oh no, Rayceen, I'm gonna be the only DJ for the Mini Bowl. I'm coming. And I would be there, and he would do it free. And then here this man gets paid thousands of dollars.
Yes, yes.
And would do it for free, like all of our other DJs. But he had something, and I've known him for over 25 years. And he was so wonderful. I think about all the times we would sit and smile and laugh. And he was a ballroom icon.
Yes, he was. Yes, he was. You know, it was such a pleasure having him for the mini balls because he really put you into the mood for a ball, honey. When you walk through those Ask Rayceen Show doors for the mini ball and you heard one on the track, honey, you were in the mood, you were in the spirit, you were feeling ready for the ballroom, honey. And you know, his work will continue to be a part of the soundtrack of, you know, queer people all over. It will continue to be that way. So, you know, rest in peace and power to Vjuan Allure. Now, of course, Rayceen, you also experienced a very personal loss this year. What would you like to say to the Ask Rayceen Show audience about your mother?
That I pray, my prayer for all of those, that you would have a mother like my mom, who was, she loved me unconditionally. She allowed me to be all that I could be. She instilled in me so many amazing things. All that you see, all of how I care about my community. My mother was a social worker for over 40 years. She took me everywhere. She showed me the importance of giving back to community, the importance of what community is about, giving. She taught me the greatest gift was to be in service. So I continue to be in service and honor her legacy, honor her light, and honor her in everything that I do. My mother was my greatest champion. And I take all of that love with me on this next journey because I know that I have another ancestor watching over me and guiding me along the way. So when I hear that voice that says, no, don't go there, don't do that, that's my mother whispering and letting me know. And then when I hear that voice saying, yes, you can, you will and you shall, you are all of that. That's her telling me and letting me know that she believes in where I'm going and what I do. So I honor my mother and I speak her name, Miss Mary Chandler, who I love dearly. May she rest in peace and power.
Beautiful. For all of you out there who we did not name, we thank you for everything you've done over the past 10 years.
It's been quite a journey from the humble beginnings of the Ask Rayceen Show back in 2012 to the show's legendary status today. I know my administration has participated in your show over the years, and I'm so happy to have the opportunity to offer my personal gratitude to you and to your equally legendary and iconic team, Rayceen, Zara, Krylios, Niqui, Monique, and so many others. Together, you created a space where people could find community and be seen and heard. You really did it all on your show. You gave people guidance and advice. You encouraged people to practice safe sex. You registered new voters and you reminded our residents of the importance of being vaccinated, wearing our mask, and following critical health guidance. And all along, you've made us DC proud. So congratulations. While the Ask Rayceen Show might be ending, I know we haven't seen the last of you, Rayceen, and we're all excited to see what's next.
Here we are, everyone, our penultimate edition and the final panel discussion for the Ask Rayceen Show.
Yes.
Viewers, it's been a journey. Yes, it has. And the last couple years have been some of the roughest, particularly for our producer, Zar. He had been planning the final 2 years of the Ask Rayceen Show in detail for several years. Then coronavirus disrupted everything. We had our season premiere in March 2020, and the rest of the season did not happen, including a disastrous attempt at a season finale about which we will not speak. Zar had to reimagine the 10th and final season as an online event, and here we are. According to Zara, the past 9 months have been among the most challenging, disappointing, frustrating, and unpleasant he's ever experienced. For context and for the record, 2020 was full of uncertainty. We originally thought our April 2020 edition would be postponed for several weeks. After that, it was all speculation. Amongst this group, some thought we'd be back to normal by the summer, while others thought autumn dates were a long shot and soon resigned themselves to the year being canceled. Now, let's talk a little bit about some of the challenges, trials, and tribulations each of us have faced over the last couple years. Let's start with Niqui.
I mean, I could go down an endless list of technological challenges over the past year, psychological challenges over the past year, financial challenges over the past year. But I'm going to say that each one of these challenges has made us stronger. We're more agile now as a team. And it's brought us closer together too, because I think it's caused us to say, okay, well, what are you good at? Okay, you take care of that. And, you know, I'll take care of this. And that would not have happened had there not been a certain amount of gritting of teeth and gnashing of teeth and furrowing of brows. So yeah, there have been challenges on so many levels, but we're still here.
Love it. Monique, what about you? Any insights on this?
I mean, you know, the thing about us going into the 2020s is that we had to do a lot of things to find out just new ways of doing things. So that just brought about, you know, honestly, new opportunities. So even though it was kind of difficult to actually get back to normal, which we may not ever get to, but along the way, after all these challenges, we're better in a sense. You know, we've learned so much. I mean, we've had to pull teeth from some people, millennials and elders alike, when it came to this technological divide. We all had to go through a retraining, have to understand, scheduling was crazy. We didn't know if we were coming or going. So, you know, it was just an opportunity to learn more. No one has gone through 2020 and 2021 like we have as a team, and we're still here. So, you know, it is what it is, good or bad.
There we go, Rayceen.
Child, where do I begin? I mean, it. What hurts the most is the live experience, the rush, the feeling. You know, I miss my high kicks. Everyone misses my high kicks. They're legendary.
How did you reach so far?
Yes, child, they're legendary. New hip and all, legendary. You know, so, I mean, I miss that feeling, me seeing people in the audience, the feedback. Because you can catch somebody and your whole energy can shift according to what's they're going on. And then people coming to you after the show and say, you know, I really had a bad day today, but I had so much fun here. And I miss my hugs. You know, I miss hugs. I miss hugging people. And, you know, I miss a good hug. I miss all that. But what I must say, in spite of everything, when everything hit and all the madness and the chaos, and all of everything feeling lost, we shook it, we pulled it together, we rewrapped it, honey, and called it a whole new gift called the YouTube channel Team Rayceen on YouTube. And that gift was presented in a way that it was mesmerizing to me, we did. And it's amazing. We just created out of nothing a whole new level of how we're going to rework and how we reinvent and how we recreated the Team Rayceen experience. And I mean, get ready for so much more of coming. So much more. We have, honey, we took lemons and made lemonade.
Yes.
Listen, and in 2022, we're about to spike that lemonade. So get ready.
Oh, get okay. ready. Get ready.
Get ready. Yeah.
Spike it. Yes. Spiking it, spiking it. I love it. Let's talk a little bit about ending the Ask Rayceen show after 10 years. We would like to point out that this has been the plan for quite some time. For those who paid attention, the Autumn 2019 flyer, which was printed in July and distributed in August of that year, listed the next year as being the penultimate one. So everyone, why end the show after 10 years?
It was time, you know, after being involved in community for well over 40 years, but then creating the Ask Rayceen show for 10 years, it was time. It was time. We did some amazing things with what we had. We opened the door, we created safe spaces, we did all that, all for free. And it was amazing what we did with the help of all our sponsors, all our volunteers. Let me just say, for those who have all these budgets and money and been real shady and have not done what they're really supposed to do, we smoked them.
Oh, yeah.
We smoked them in a way that the shade was real. The shade that they threw when we would call and ask for help, we got a lot of shade along the way. So let us know we was doing something right. So at the end, when it was time to end, it's time to end because a new beginning. Yeah. It's like graduating and now we're going to college and college costs.
Yeah.
You know, so fame costs, and right here is where you start paying. You know, so we want to do other things, and we got Team Rayceen has our hands in so many avenues and so many directions that I'm really proud. I was scared at first. I was scared. I was worried. I didn't know what to think. I didn't want to let go of my baby after 10 years, and it was hard. Yeah. But look at all the joy that came with it.
Mm-hmm.
Proclamation from the mayor's office.
Yeah.
And the proclamation having the one only time of the Ask Rayceen Day, celebrating 10 years of all the work that we did. And that was a labor of love. Not too many witches can say that, okay?
Hey,
and we did it, and we did it well. So those who can't say that, suffer.
Hey. Suffer, honey, yes, suffer. Yes.
I mean, we are so fortunate to have such an amazing legacy to springboard so many new ideas from. The Ask Rayceen show is the variety show of a decade. And from that, we have met so many amazing friends, have formed so many amazing new connections, and have found support in the most unlikeliest places. And we are so grateful for that, and even more grateful for those individuals who want to ride with us for another 10 years. It's amazing. I mean, 2022 is really going to be some kind of wonderful. And I'm just so grateful to everyone who's been with us and everyone who's committed to continuing to go where we've never been before. You know,
I love that. Yes, yes, yes. Because, you know, Team Rayceen Productions does so much, you know, as Rayceen and Niqui pointed out, have, you know, hands in so many different parts, doing so many other things. And we cannot wait to put forth, you know, more content, more love, more community, more entertainment, more education, all of it. In 2021 and beyond, honey, a multitude of other events and activities. Yeah. So, you know, even though we are coming to the end of the Ask Rayceen show, there is so much more on the horizon. And so we are so, so, so excited for it. And with all the things that we've done, we have had some amazing, terrific volunteers over the years. Yes. Yes, yes, we have, including Donald, Brittany, MD, Jason, Monique, Hunty. Yes. but one person has helped both at events and behind the scenes for several years. So all of us here and Zar would especially like to thank our photographer, videographer, video editor, and go-to person, Jeff, for everything he has done over the years, including his work on Team Rayceen YouTube channel videos and everything he's done for the Ask Rayceen show. We truly couldn't have done it without you, Jeff.
Yes,
honey.
We love you, Jeff.
Yeah,
you. Jeff is you. Just so shy. We always had to, hey, Jeff, how you doing? Come take my picture over here. Look at that person right there. He was just like the shyest dude, but then afterwards, he took like the greatest shots. I mean, like the greatest action shots. I mean, Rayceen in those high kicks. Jeff got it all up here, yes. Down around the corner. He was always everywhere. So Jeff is definitely the man. Yeah, I know people never see him, but he definitely is the man. Yes.
So awesome. Yes,
Jeff, come through. So the Ask Rayceen show. Okay. So the Ask Rayceen show had several annual events each year, including the mini ball and poetry slam. But yes, there was also a monthly ritual that took place most evenings, which was the post-show party outside of the HRC building. Yes, honey, we would be there for a good minute after the show was done, hanging out till even midnight.
The after party was lit.
I enjoyed it so much, Rayceen. Talk about some of those times.
Child, it was the decompressing and the laugh that we would laugh at everything that went wrong. We would talk about everything that went right. We would sit and eat our chips and our little leftover snacks and our sodas. And we would just talk and laugh because we just needed to decompress. And we were, you know, honey, we would sit out in front of HRC on the wall. And we would watch the rats and the hookers, honey. You know, it was just all strolling in the late hour. And you know, and the cover of darkness. But we just had so much fun. I mean, it was good because we needed that. And we would laugh and tell stories and just unwind. It was like
I was just talking to the producer, Czar. I didn't even know that you guys even did this because like after I passed out my gift bags and wished everybody farewell, see you later, I would go and decompress in my car after a long day of work, dancing at the show.
Yeah, sometimes we would order food. Remember sometimes we would order pizzas and have
Yes, honey, yes. You would be sitting out there laughing, talking, gallivanting. Baby, we just... Yeah, lives,
but listen, quiet as it's kept.
From the show that I missed out on?
Well, let me also say that we spent a lot of time packing and unpacking vehicles. And so that also was a reason why I think everybody was like, okay, we out.
Exactly, because we're packing and unpacking, honey.
Talk about unpacking. Remember how many carts? I think two of our carts died and we gave them a funeral in front of HRC. We laid them in front of a tree and they rested there forever.
And you know, for those girls who drank a little bit too much during the show, honey, they needed that little after party time to just relax.
Sober up
a little bit.
Throw up. Get it out your system.
We're heading home, honey. Oh. Listen.
Oh my goodness.
There have been on more than one occasions we've had to spend, you know, a few hours with somebody who had a little bit too much to drink, honey. We gotta be like, girl. Yes, honey. So we enjoyed those moments. We enjoyed those moments.
Awesome.
Those were really, really fun. And, you know, some of the moments that we certainly do miss from the live Ask Rayceen show experience. Yes.
But, you know, I do want to say this because, yes, you know, I miss a lot of different things, but we're still the edutainers at heart. And so the online universe and the on-site universe we've been able to really travel between those two worlds. And I'm just loving the way things are starting to materialize as we're having the opportunity to do things on site under certain circumstances. So I'm strongly encouraging everyone who's watching this to go to Rayceen.com so that you can stay informed about the events that we have coming up, because we do have some on-site events that are happening and we're still doing online. I mean, we've done hundreds of shows online. Hundreds. It's amazing. Yes, it's amazing. So, you know, not to brag on the team, just saying that, you know, anybody watching this, I know that there's trepidation about change, but when you embrace the new and you stop looking back, you have an opportunity to make magic continue to happen. And that's what Team Rayceen Productions is committed to doing. We're the same edutainers that you love and that you're going to continue to interact with in the future.
Yes, I love that. Great to know that, Niqui. So we want to discuss the venues and the evolution of the show. So let's get into it. As you can see on the infographic, the Ask Rayceen Show, not to be confused with other events produced by Team Rayceen Productions or hosted by Rayceen Pendarvis, was primarily at three venues: MLK Library, Live Nightclub, and the HRC Equality Center. I was only at HRC, but our producer Zara has stated that being at Live Nightclub and pre-renovation MLK Library had its fair set of challenges, let's say that. Rayceen, tell us a little bit more about that.
Darkness. Oh. I'm reminded of darkness, and how we have to bring in our own lighting, you know, something. I mean, it was, I love the library, the wonderful library, but I love the library now, the new reiterator.
Yes.
Oh,
it's fabulous.
But gorgeous. Honey, we would be down in that basement and it would sometimes the lights would be off and they would not be working. We had one row that was out, two rows off, one row on, and we had to bring in our own lighting. So we took lights like this. And we hooked them up. Sometimes the sound wasn't right. Sometimes we had to get the sound together. We'd have one working mic or the batteries would go out. But I must say, the technician who worked at MLK Library, he was amazing. He would work, go to another library, get us some mics, come back, go get to CVS, get us some batteries, come back. He, when things were not working, he jumped in.
Writer.
Yeah, but let's even talk about Liv, child. Liv, mm-hmm. First of all, some days you wouldn't feel like that two flights. Good enough.
Oh my God.
Carrying our carts and boxes and bags and getting up there. But once we got up there, it was great once we got up there. And then sometimes we would worry about, you know, the wonderful sofa that would be missing the following time we come back, or a couple of chairs would be gone, or the wobbling chairs. And, you know, we would have to put boxes underneath the chair. We would have to put boxes in the chair. Yeah. And cover them up with tablecloths and stuff like that. We were also the cleaning staff. We would have to come in here because their staff was limited. And I loved their bartending. Their bartending and food was amazing. But we would have to come in here and mop, sweep, redecorate. And then after we moved it up, we would have to move it back.
Yes.
Not all that. Oh, girl.
Lock the windows so the light wouldn't come through, because sometimes the light would come through and it would come through and it would be backlighting. So we even brought our own props to block the light.
Well, it shows the Ask Rayceen Show truly a labor of love, making it happen wherever, whenever, However, yes. Honey, yes. Always coming through. So, of course, the Ask Rayceen Show changed venues and adjusted the formats over the years. Many of the most noteworthy changes took place after Azar became the producer and created Team Rayceen. This included the participation of DJs, the inclusion of burlesque, regularly occurring music performances, our season premiere, and sexy season finale, bringing in vendors and visual artists, interviews with politicians, connecting with headcount voter registration, and acquiring sponsors. I want everyone to share some of their insights about how the show developed over the years. Rayceen, you started the whole thing. Talk to me about this development.
We grew into a whole nother element at HRC. And like Zara said, and his work speaks for itself, he sat down with me and had a vision. He believed in the process of trusting the process, you know, and he would push me and sometimes would say things and do things that arrange things and put things together. And sometimes I had to step back and I had to trust the process and trust his vision enough to know that our vision was the same in the end. However we got there, we were going to get down to the end of the road. He just took another avenue to get there. And I had another avenue, but then we got back to the end of the road. So it was like understanding and trusting the and trust and believe. Now we had some teeth pulling and we had some hair pulling and some disagreements along the way, but we believed in the sense of community. We believed in Team Rayceen. We believed in uplifting the community and creating something that was bigger than ourselves. So Czar has created something that will, he stamped something and he put something together and brought everybody in place. And he did something that only he could do.
Yeah.
I love it. I love it. Certainly that has seeing the show develop, even with the short time I've been there, seeing just so many different things happen. It's been such a beautiful wonder to watch. It's just great seeing, you know, this beautiful show growing from strength to strength to strength, no matter, you know, where we are, no matter what happens, you know, it's always giving, it's always developing, it's always growing. And, you know, it's always there entertaining and educating for everybody else. So we want to wrap this up. So as we do, please share your vision for Team Rayceen Productions in the future. Niqui.
For me?
Oh, Monique.
Oh, sorry. I didn't know. Okay. I would like to see more artists come in, more gifts from our communities being shown and developed, more demonstrations. The one thing that I remember, and this wasn't really, you know, as the Ask Rayceen Show to me was always flashy and fun and just, you know, exciting. But also too, they did demonstrations. When we were in the HRC, we started doing more demonstrations. I like the cooking demonstration. I like the sex toy demonstration. I like the whips and chains demonstration. All those things that were coming together that involved people, you know, getting out of their shell. It definitely brought me out of my shell and made me more comfortable with my own self and dealing with a lot of people. But I just cannot wait till we come back together so we can bring that type of energy to our community again. I miss you guys.
Yes, Niqui.
I co-sign on everything that Monique said. And I'm just so excited about the strong foundation that's been set with 10 years of edutaining. And I'm looking forward to doing similar things with a twist, as I said. Get ready for some spiked lemonade. It's coming.
Yes. Well, I just look forward to, you know, Team Rayceen Productions growing from strength to strength and really being that purveyor of pop, purveyor of art, purveyor of entertainment, purveyor of education, purveyor of community building, not just here, not just nationally, but across the universe, honey, across the stars, baby. See you in the Andromeda galaxy, hunty. We'll see you there. That's my hope, my wish for Team Rayceen. Rayceen, close us out with your final wish for the future.
Well, it'd have to be three. I would say three wishes.
Give it.
That we all get paid and the way that we are truly worth.
Wow.
And I believe that it's all coming because we've paid the price and we have done the work to get there. And I believe all that I see the blessings abundantly pouring down and coming down. I see that my second wish would be that when one door opens or one door closes, a window opens, a light comes through, something else comes through. It's like we are now we are now in a cocoon and we're getting ready to become a butterfly and soar to heights unimaginable. And that's where we are, that this chapter is just another journey. And my third wish, I can't tell you, we're gonna show you.
I was gonna say, don't give all the tea.
Catch it, that's all I'm gonna say is catch it.
Yes, honey, catch it. It has been a fabulous run, fabulous 10 years. And honestly, I've had no greater joy than working with Team Rayceen for all the years that I have so far. So thank you all for being here with me. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for all the work that, you know, is put into the Ask Rayceen show and Team Rayceen production. So on behalf of Team Rayceen Productions, I thank you, the viewers, for attending, for supporting, and of course, thank you for watching. Bye, everyone.
We have a special guest. Please introduce yourself.
Hello, I am Paola Martinez, and I am an art educator here at the corner at Whitman Walker.
We have something special for you.
Oh, yes, we do. Hey, Paola.
Hello, thank you. Thank you so much. On behalf of everyone at the corner, Ruth, Sol, and I really appreciate it. Thank you, Rayceen.
That's so fabulous. And thank you. Remember, we used to end the Ask Rayceen show by doing the wobble.
Play the clip.
I want to thank y'all, everybody, for joining us and celebrating the 10 years of the Ask Rayceen show. It has been a journey. You know, this year we celebrated so many amazing things.
So we are ready to begin.
Get up.
Please join us next month for our series finale on November 3rd, 2021. Until then, check your voter status, stay moisturized, wash your hands often, and eat some cake. Thank you for watching.